Good morning, dear students. In the last class, we have discussed about the relation between the mass number and atomic number and modern periodic law. Okay, these are we are discussed in the last class. And today I am going to discuss about the long form of the periodic table. Okay, now we are studying about the long form of the periodic table. Okay, so characteristics of long form of periodic table. Long form of periodic table. Okay, what is the characteristics of long form of the periodic table? A periodic table based on the who proposed the long form of the periodic table? Based on the long form of the periodic table is based on the Bohr-Bure concept of electronic configuration. Bohr-Bure concept of electronic configuration and was proposed by Rank, Werner, Bury and others are proposed the long form of the periodic table is known as long form of the periodic table or Bohr's periodic table also we can call or we can call Bohr's periodic table. Okay, this periodic table is based on the Bohr-Bure concept of electronic configuration and was proposed by Rank, Werner, Bury and others. This is known as long form of periodic table or Bohr's periodic table. It contains 7 periods and 18 groups. What is the periods? Horizontal rows are called periods. What is the groups? Vertical columns are called groups. How many groups is there in the periodic table? 18 groups is there and 7 periods is there. What is the periods? Horizontal rows are called periods. Vertical columns are called groups. Okay. A periodic table based on Bohr-Bure is a scientist based on Bohr-Bure concept of electronic configuration. Electronic configuration and was proposed by which scientist? Proposed by Rank, Werner, Bury, Rank, Werner, Bury and others and is known as what we can call known as long form of periodic table and is known as long form of periodic table. PT means periodic table. You have to write the complete periodic table, don't write the PT. Okay, is known as long form of periodic table or we can call Bohr's table. Okay, long form of periodic table or Bohr's periodic table. Generally, this periodic table, before that, only 63 elements is there. At that time, different scientists, they are classified the elements into the groups and periods. Okay. So now 118 elements is there. Okay. So some scientists are demerits is there. They are arranging the elements in the order of increasing atomic mass. I will discuss everything. Okay. Now. This is called long form of periodic table or Bohr's periodic table. This periodic table, just you have to observe the points. Okay. So what is the long form of periodic table? In this, how many groups is there? How many periods is there? And elements, how they are arranging? And what are the portions is there? Like that you have to observe. Now, it contains 7 periods. Okay. Long form of periodic table having the 3 portions. Long form of the periodic table having 3 portions. What is the 3 portions? three portions. One is the left portion. One is the left portion. Okay, what is the left portion? On the extreme left side portion is called left portion. These are having the groups 1 and 2. That is the first A and second A groups. That is the first A and second A groups elements. These include alkali and alkali earth metals or S block elements. These are having the strong electropositive character. Okay. Left side portion, I will send the periodic table. Okay, left side portion. We are going to discuss about the left side portion. Left side portion having the two groups. Which is the groups? 1 and 2. We can call the first A and second A also. First A group and second A group elements are called left side portion. These include alkali and alkali earth metals. Alkali and alkali earth metals are S block elements. These are having strong electropositive character. On the extreme left side, extreme left or group, left or group 1 and group 2, group 1 and group 2, that is first A and second A, that is first A and second A groups elements. That is first A and second A group elements. These includes, these includes alkali and alkali earth metals or S block elements. These are having strong electropositive character. So what is the electropositive character? They are losing the electron from their valency shell, that is called electropositivity. Losing electron capacity is more, is there means they are having the more electropositive. Okay, first A and second A group elements, alkali metals and alkali earth metals, are these are the two metals, strong electropositive metals. Electropositive character means they lose the electrons easily. That character is known as electropositive character. And right portion. Next portion is the right portion. Okay, what is the right portion? On the extreme right are groups 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. These are called first 3rd A, 4th A, 5th A, 6th A, 7th A group and 0 group elements. Most of the elements are non-metals. Okay, right side portion. On the extreme right are groups. On the extreme right are groups 13th group and 14th group, 15th group, 16th group, 17th group and 0 group. 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th and 0 group, that is 3rd A group, 4th A group, 5th A group, 6th A group, 7th A group and 0, 7th A and 0 group, 7th A and 0 group. Okay, these groups are called right portion. Okay, in the right portion, which groups is there? 13th group, 14th group, 15th, 16th, 17th, and 0 group is there. Okay, 3rd year, 4th year, 5th year, we can call the 3rd year, 4th year, 5th year, 6th year, 7th year, and 0 group. So what is the these groups? I will send the periodic table, then you have to get the clear idea. So most of the elements are non-metals. Right side portion elements, most of the elements are non-metals. Okay, so next one, the middle portion, last portion is a periodic table having the three portions. One is the left portion, one is the right portion, and the next one is the middle portion. So this portion is further divided into two parts. The middle portion is further divided into how many parts? Two parts. One is a transition elements and another one is a inner transition elements. Okay, the middle portion is further divided into two parts. One is a middle transition elements, another one is a inner transition elements. Okay, what is a transition elements, what is the inner transition elements, we can discuss in the next class. Okay, thank you.